up, I'm fired up.
Don't run from rap.
1, 2, 3. Hey. I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. Game time. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war.
I just got 20, I'm running on empty. This mobile that came from my money is silly. I feel the envy, not trying to be friendly. It is what it is, if you want me, come get me. Whenever you ready, no, I keep it steady. I get the W, throw the confetti. Please do not tempt me, don't hold it against me. We about that action, don't ever forget it. Squad of guerrillas, the army, the navy. When I call a play, I'ma score like I'm Brady. The title is mine, if you want it, come take it.
I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war. I'm ready for more.
Oh, it's hard in the field, yeah, we
tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war.
If you looking for me, you know where to find me. I leave you dusted, I leave you behind me. I flip the switch from 0 to 90. If you do too much, I'ma do the almighty. You know I got it, you know I'm a legend. You know I'm the one, I do not come in second. Please do not tempt me, don't hold it against me. We about that action, don't ever forget it. Squad of guerrillas, the army, the navy. When I call a play, I'ma score like I'm Brady. The title is mine, if you want it, come take it.
I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war. I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war.
What up, man?
So I'm back with my brother and it's together.
Only religion was the moolah. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a toy. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework. I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chillin', click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real, about to get real. That's just how I'm feeling.
Hey, Belly.
Them ready?
Yeah. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's
them gyal a red eye, never make right. Me they a suffer life, them a get by. Never bow for the fame, heads high. The back of me so all them a see a tear light. Been a real from the ghetto. I ain't never gon' switch, that's facts though. Can't get me out like stain. Come a grow tough, I'ma know pain. Haters talk with a bad tongue. Can't break me, twiddle be so dumb. I'ma be a giant P5-0 from doing it so big like Drake, I'm on one. My big box got me feeling so bossy. Like Lauren Hill, me I kill them softly. This a girl rather fi be called a naughty. Cause if my too loyal, then it's gon' cost me. And
that's just how I feel.
Yeah.
That's just how I'm feeling.
That's how I feel.
Dog, that's just how I'm feeling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling. Big boss, I'm a big boss. Up north, Rick Ross. I got the pump that'll make you jump. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Don't you ever get it crisscross. I got the pump that'll make you jump. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Bet against me, that's a big love. You about to find out what the call. I get low, lift off. It ain't nothing to cut the off. Stop frying, don't let it get soft. Covered in yolk, in yolk. Wonder why I got the whole world pissed off. That's just how I'm feeling. Dog, that's just how I'm feeling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling.
Today, from Gillette Stadium in Foxborough, it's week one of the NFL on EA Sports.
Coverage of the National Football League brings us to Gillette Stadium in Foxborough, Mass. A moment ago, the pride of Massachusetts, the Patriots, introduced to this, as always, sold-out crowd as they get set to go head-to-head with the Miami Dolphins. Again, everyone, Brandon Gordon, so happy to be with you to kick off this much-anticipated 2021 season. With me in the booth as we begin our sixth season together is, of course, Charles Davis. And CD, so much to watch for coming up. What are you keeping an eye on?
Well, Brandon, I'm ecstatic to be back with you, of course, and we've got a good one right here out of the gates. I'm interested in seeing some of the changes in 2021. Running backs and wideouts, even linebackers wearing single-digit numbers. But even more than that, I want to see the changes defenses have made, because last year, we averaged 49.6 points per game. That's the highest ever by three full points. Can these defenses make an adjustment and start to catch up?
Yeah, passer rating, CD, an all-time high. Completion percentage, also an all-time high. So as you said, will those numbers continue to climb northward, or will the defenses adjust? Carry for Damian Harris, the Alabama man, and he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he's trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
Harris going to get it again on second down. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
And that's a run characteristic of Damian Harris. When he touches it, he gets not what's just blocked, but he gets a few more yards as well. He's been dinged up his first 2 years with the Patriots, only 10 starts a year ago. But you have to believe that this coaching staff thinks that he's capable of bigger and better things.
And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. There you go, Charles, the first completed pass of his young career.
And we expect it not to be his last. Very good to get the first one out of the way, though, as he begins his career.
Now a first down carry for Harris. And he's going to get this inside the 30.
To describe that one, I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid game.
Now left side on the swing pass. So the completion good for 6 yards. And that'll make this a second down. A nice throw right there. And these fans getting their first look at their QB1 of the future. I'd imagine it's got to be a big plus for him to get his first start here in front of that home crowd.
I know there's a school of thought about getting your first start away from home so you don't have the extra pressure of that crowd behind you. But I say ride the wave. Embrace it. Go ahead and play to that level. And I think it's going to benefit him in the long run.
They'll run on first down. Harris, he's going to get 4 out of this as he's down to the 10-yard line.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other 3 here on third down? Now Jones. Touchdown, Patriots! Jacoby Myers, a 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Patriots are on the board here first in the season opener. Extra point right down the middle. And it's now a 7-0 game. So that drive consumes 9 plays all told. And it's finished off by a Pats touchdown. Noah Igbinoghene from his end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Dolphins ready to go to work on offense, led by their second-year quarterback out of Alabama. It's Tua Tagovailoa.
Absolutely no one's surprised. The Dolphins did invest a high first-round pick, number 5 overall, to draft Tua in 2020. I think that most people would say that his rookie year had plenty of positives, but it was sprinkled with a few negatives as well. Remember, he controversially took over for Ryan Fitzpatrick during the open week prior to week 8. Miami did go 6-3 in his starts from that time, but he had to get rescued a few times in games by Fitzmagic. And in his own words, he called his rookie year below average. I don't think the franchise believes that, but they're looking forward to seeing him improve.
And they worked this well upfield across the 45.
Something to watch here in week 1 of the season, tackling. Because you and I both know that in the preseason, a lot of these guys don't play a whole lot. Plus, the intensity and the speed really ratchets up on opening week.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down. You don't see that a ton, do you? Or the cornerback coming over to the middle of the field to make a run tackle.
That's someone with a ton of confidence to feel like nothing is pressuring him on his side of the field. Sees that the ball's moved to the middle and just sprints over there to help out. He ends up getting the tackle. Well played.
And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46. Try and run for it with Lindsey. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
Counting down toward the midway point in quarter 1. get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense? Was that five straight runs?
Yeah, five straight carries to start this drive, and like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. Two is thrown here, taken in by Got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots 23. This is shaping up to be a really nice-looking drive to get the season underway here.
And how long do you think that they actually have been plotting this drive? I'm talking about the coaching staff, right? They've been thinking about this for a while now, and I think they're executing it even better than what they expected.
Tua now on first down. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Now a play fake. Here's Tagovailoa. Out to the flat here for Johnson. That helps the completion percentage, but not much else, and now it's third and 10.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. You're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
Escaping the pressure right. Yeah, this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they... ...love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
The kick by Sanders is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So, yes, it's only three, but at least they're able to answer back after giving up the touchdown to start the game.
Yeah, I like the observation there because getting some points on the board, very positive for them. Feel a little bit better about things because if you don't score, you potentially have opened the door for them to score again, and then you're down 14.
Olszewski going to hold on to this one. Touchback. So back onto the field come the Pats for their second drive. And, Charles, nothing like squaring off with a division opponent, a division rival in week one. Do you like that they are matching up this early, or would you prefer a game like this be a few weeks down the road?
I actually like the early matchup for a few reasons, Brandon. First of all, it allows you to see that in the entire offseason and know, hey, right out of the gate, we're playing a division game. Second part is it spreads them out a little bit. If you just have them all bunched up at the end of the year, that's not as much fun watching teams try to survive that gauntlet when you do have injuries down the stretch. And last but not least, let's face it, we're TV people. What a great game to sell right out of the gate.
First down, and they go back to Harris. And that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
When a draw works, it can be a thing of beauty. But when it doesn't, oh, it can be ugly. And in this case, loss of yardage ugly.
Meanwhile, Jones' throw there complete to Myers. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. Another completion there, and you think about the draft back in the spring. He's selected in the first round, getting the start here, as we mentioned, in week one. It's got to be quite a whirlwind for a young quarterback.
Absolutely, because going in the first round, people are going to clamor for you to be the starter right away, but many teams want you to get your feet wet first, you know, maybe just kind of hang out behind a veteran starter. In this case, though, he ascended right to the top role, and I know he's excited about the opportunity.
Now on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. This will be taken at the 10. It'll be a 48-yard punt. Five there on the return. And the Dolphins' drive will start deep in their own territory with a first and 10. So Miami coming out for their second drive. They finished off their opening drive of the campaign with a field goal on the last drive. Now they'll search for a touchdown here on this goal round, first and 10. Play action, now it's Tua. And he's taken down. Back at his own 7. Dietrich Wise just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7. Well, on that one, they go with a play fake, CD, but I don't think anybody really was fooled. All eyes were fixated on the quarterback, and they got him to the ground.
And to run this play successfully, you've got to make sure that everyone is doing their part.
Looking for Johnson, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Dante Hightower, and he'll bring it back to the 9-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on-the-job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll get about 4 there as he takes it from the 10 down to the 6. And after getting tackled, he's still down and looking very slow to get up. The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. Boy, not what you want to see in quarter one of the new year. We'll be back. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop him right around the 1. It'll be a gain of 5, and it's going to set up a 3rd and goal. Now, Charles, we take a peek there at the recent draft class, and this definitely a year where they had a chance to greatly improve this team.
And you've got to take advantage when you have this type of an opportunity.
And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Ramondre Stevenson with his first career touchdown in his first career game. And the Patriots add 6 to their lead. Rohrwasser on for the PAT. This one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. So they only needed 3 plays on that drive. And it was polished off by a Ramondre Stevenson touchdown run. This fielded right at the goal line. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Dolphins offense now working their way back onto the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
They'll start on the ground with Lindsey. And he's got a good gain of 7 up to the 37. You often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
And now the throw going to Fuller, and he's got it. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35.
And, partner, they're locked in man coverage out left, and they end up running a crossing route. Rounded it a little bit more than a slant. He's just going to angle himself towards the right side of the field, and that's very difficult for a defender to shadow him across all that ground.
Line of scrimmage moves from 137-yard line to the other as they come up first and 10. Meanwhile, Tua's throw here taken in by Parker. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. After 1, a 14-3 ball game. First foray into the red zone for Miami. First and 10 at the 19. From the gun, it's Tua. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Lawrence Guy able to get in there and drop him for a loss.
It's interesting, partner, that most defenses try and guard the 35-yard line actively because they think the way kickers are nowadays, about a 52-yard field goal, they're kind of giving up points. But you get even deeper into territory, you get into the red zone, they're going to guard it even more, which means more pressure, more blitzing.
It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down.
Well executed there on second down, so do you go back to the air on third?
Well, that's a possibility, but now you've opened up things to where you showed that you would run the ball in a long-distance situation. You might come back again because I doubt they believe you'll do it a second time.
Out of the gun on third down, here's Tua. There's a first NFL catch for the first-rounder, Jaylen Waddle.
Great mix of play calling so far. Three runs, three passes. All three passes have been completions. First and goal.
I think on defense now, you have to almost take a chance. Rely on your scouting. Pick a play you think they would run here and just load up for it and see what happens.
They'll run with Lindsay.
And he's able to get it down to the two-yard line. It'll be a pickup of four, and it brings up second and goal.
When you look at the geography we're staring at, this part of the field, don't you always think of big backs carrying the football, bruisers trying to pound it in? Instead, we're looking at a little more of a scat back type, and he's trying to make it happen.
Yeah, they went with the elusive, slippery guy. Couldn't get in there, though. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down.
Sometimes you get all those big guys down there in one spot, and there's just nowhere to go. And in this case, the defensive tackle used his strength and swallowed him up.
The Dolphins on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. They're looking at a third and goal here.
Tua going to tap this forward on a jet sweep.
And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the 6.
Well, they're trying to catch him by surprise, I think, there with that little pop pass on third down, but no luck.
You're right about no luck, but I did like the idea. I like the thought process. Make an unconventional call on third down sometimes. It can pop big. In this case, it didn't.
No problems in the field goal department so far. He's 2 for 2.
Pretty reliable here in this game, isn't he? And to me, that bodes well for them. If they need him late in the game, his confidence should be sky high.
After the field goal, here comes Sanders to kick it away. Olszewski going to hold on to this one. Touchback. Damian Harris of the Patriot offense ready to take over again.
He's over 40 yards here in the second quarter. Been nice and effective for them, hasn't he?
He has definitely been dependable and really shouldn't underestimate what he's getting done here, because anytime you're on a pace that's going to approach 100 yards, you've really done some damage in an NFL game.
And now he's looking just to add to his totals.
57 yards rushing for him in this first half as he is looking at mid-season form here in the opener.
Again, it's Harris on second down. Well, you talked about the need for them to establish the run early. They've been able to do that here in the first half.
And that means that the whole offense has adopted that attitude and that persona. We're going to take care of this young quarterback. Let's all get together and run it and take the pressure off.
They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. They hand this off to Harris. And some space here. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory.
And this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack. And guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
Stevenson now on 1st and 10.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right at a yard. The last run got 9. That leaves him with 2nd and a yard. On the handoff, Stevenson. And this time not as successful, as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. They'll say no gain on the play, so it was looking good, but nothing there. And now it's 3rd down and inches. Trying to pick it up on the ground with Harris. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a 1st down. Throwing, Jones. And his throw here is incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
On second down, this is Harris. Down to the 30 after a gain of 3. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
Open man is Jacoby Myers. He's got it. And he will have a Patriots first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. A nice completion there for the first down. And, Charles, you think about the quarterbacks of recent vintage that have been thrust into action week one. It's no guarantee of future success, but we sure have seen some good ones.
We certainly have, partner. How about Joe Burrow with the Bengals in 2020? He was excellent. Kyler Murray with the Cardinals. The best part about his game, had his team run the brink of the playoffs. And Deshaun Watson has won division titles after having started from day one.
And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. Now a first and 10 at the 11. Back to throw. Jones. And he's going to go down. He sacked back in the 24. Emmanuel Ogba that time able to drop him for a loss. Now then, after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23.
Boy, Charles, that time he took a bad situation and made it worse.
Yeah, you're almost putting together a nice little song there, aren't you? Because it's something you'll see from young quarterbacks. They have that tendency to retreat backwards instead of stepping up in the pocket.
They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. Looking to throw. He'll be hit and taken down at the 21. Now it looks like we've got a Patriot down. Slow to get up. Hate to see this. Week one of the season. We'll be back. Justin Rohrwasser now for the Patriot field goal. On the left hash mark, this a 38-yard attempt. Rohrwasser's kick is good. And that will extend their lead here to 17-6. So that one on target, and it adds to this first half lead.
And maybe we're too early to worry too much about one-score lead, two-score lead, etc. But this is where you kind of start banking those points that come in helpful later on.
And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Getting set to go again on offense. Here's Devontae Parker now. With them losing here in the second quarter and his limited productivity so far, you'd have to think they're going to try to look to him a little bit more, right?
I would guess you would start to see maybe some quick screens, some hitches, anything to get the ball in his hands quickly and let him try and do some damage after the catch. Or maybe just flip some formations and keep him isolated where it's more of a one-on-one route and get the ball to him.
I said just four verts, right?
Hey, why not? Four verts, one of the best routes in football. Hard to cover each guy all the way along the route.
So far, just one catch for him. He'll get that out wide to Waddle. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll again head down to visit with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando, back for another year. He'll have scores from around the NFL here on this opening weekend. On the handoff, it's Gaskin. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40.
A nice substantial run there by Gaskin, who was the Dolphins' leading rusher in 2020. 584 total yards in just 7 starts and got stronger as the season went on. Not bad for a 7th-round pick. He was drafted number 234 overall that season.
He'll get this to his tight end, Gesicki. That catch good for only a couple. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
From the 38, Tua.
He dumps it underneath here to Lindsey.
And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Now Tua. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
On play action, here's Tua. And an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number one. So back-to-back incompletions. Third down here, Tim, but you're still in field goal range.
And that's the thing to keep in mind. They're in field goal range. So now you don't take any unnecessary risks, but you try and find a way to get back to what you were doing earlier in the drive in order to finish this one off.
Screenplay, Johnson. And he'll be stopped short of the first down right around the 18-yard line. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as the clock shows 50 seconds to play. First down, Tagovailoa. Completing it to the right side, Johnson. Touchdown, Dolphins. Duke Johnson from 13 yards out.
And the Dolphins get a late score here in the final minute of the first half.
Extra point up and good by Sanders. And the lead is down to 4. After the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. Olszewski going to hold on to this one. Touchback. Damian Harris of the Patriot offense ready to take over again. He's in his own second quarter, already closing in on a 100-yard game.
And that's the magic number for a running back. Anytime you get to that triple digits, that's all you're looking for. But he's got a chance to really exceed that in this one.
Yeah, he does. That's been the gold standard for a long time, hasn't it, that 100-yard mark?
It really has, and that never has to shift because it's in a game. It's a 1,000-yard mark. I'm wondering, since we've gone from 12 to 14 to 16 games, maybe we need to up that a little.
Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Myers, and he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. So we've reached... All right, we will save the Week 1 highlights and apparently get right back to the action here in the third. We'll see if Week 1 fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. The Dolphins getting set to go back to work here in quarter number 3. And they do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football first to try and do something about it.
And that certainly makes it something of an important drive for them, because is it going to win the game? No, but you have to do something to bring some life to your sideline.
Second half starts with a run by Lindsey. And he'll wind up with about 6, up past the 30 to the 31.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
On second down, right back to Lindsey.
And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
Here's Tagovailoa on first and 10. He's going to float this one deep right side. And incomplete on the deep ball.
It's been clear in this matchup which side has been the more physical one. It's been this defense. And here's another example on that last play.
On second down, it's Lindsey. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
44 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
First downs have not come easy, and neither have runs like this throughout this game.
Absolutely not. He finally felt like, whoa, a sigh of relief. We got something going in the running game. Setting to throw on first down is Tua. That's going to be caught by Waddle. Oh, he's hit. He lost the football. Put it on the carpet. And the defense not able to get it. From a defensive perspective, what's that moment like when you realize the ball is loose?
It is a moment where all concentration goes right to the football. This is something you've talked about in all your preparation for the game. You probably talked about this training camp. Knock the ball free, take it away from the other team, and now you have that chance. It's a little bit of deflation when they end up recovering it.
They knocked it free, but couldn't take it away. Third down, here's Lindsey. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been four down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, though, if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Tua's throw is taken in by Waddle. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots 16.
Miami's receivers had the second fewest yards of any receiving group in 2020. And the fewest yards in run after catch as well. Jalen Waddle, he might solve both of those problems. Taking sixth overall, he picks up a first down right there.
Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and 2. Decided to hand it off that time on the run-pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice, steady gain.
Second down, a run with Lindsey, and he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line.
I hope we give enough respect to the big guys up front because they have been getting it done on this drive. The holes have been large, and they've been barreling through and picking up first downs.
They'll try and run. This is Johnson, and the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. It's a gain of 1 yard, and it'll set up second and goal. Now whistles and a flag, and I believe a Dolphin got going a little early. And that'll set him back 5. Things made a little more difficult after the false start as they try again on second and goal. A run with Lindsey out of the gun, and he'll take this from the 9 down to about the 7. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
Sanders' kick is good, and that'll bring him back within a point. So a decent drive there to start the third quarter. They only salvaged 3 out of it, but they inch a bit closer.
Yeah, but still lots of time to go in this one. That's why you hear that clapping on the sidelines, right? Hey, got some points. As you said, inching their way back in. Time left to go out and get that victory.
Olszewski going to hold on to this one. Touchback. Here comes the Patriots offensive unit. They'll have it first here to begin the third quarter. They go play action here on first down.
The connection here with Nelson Aguilar. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
And the Patriots added Nelson Aguilar in free agency, and he's going to be part of this rebuilt receiving core from a year ago. Really upped his value around the league with a solid season with the Raiders last year, increased his confidence, as well as having a career high in receiving yards.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. They'll run again with Harris, and that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped in the backfield. It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to 3rd and 10.
I think sometimes when you're trying to get after the quarterback, maybe it's better to be lucky than great, because I think on that one, he's just trying to get upfield and rush the passer. Instead, the tackle for the loss landed right in his lap.
He'll check this one down to Taylor. They'll get only a yard out of that, and it'll bring up 4th down. The Patriots send out their punter as he'll kick it away for the 2nd time. Call that a 45-yard punt, just 2 yards there on the return. And the offense will come back out deep in their own territory. Tua and the Dolphins now with a 1st and 10 at their own 12-yard line. He'll start things with a handoff to Lindsey. And he takes us across the 15 to the 17. Up to make the tackle, J.C. Jackson. 5 yards remain on 2nd down. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. On the right side open is Gesicki. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line.
We saw this jumping jack make steady improvement his first 3 years in Miami, and he topped it off with 53 catches last year, career high. Now in his 4th season, I expect his numbers to continue to rise.
And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far at 2nd down. After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. Meanwhile, Tua's throw taken in here by Fuller. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
Simple drag route here, lined up out left. He tried to work his way back across the field. You probably saw me twitch there, partner, because I think he wanted the ball a little bit sooner. By the time he looked it in, defender was right on it.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon, and it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a 1st down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
On 1st and 10, it's Lindsey. Just a yard on the 1st down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately, he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
On 2nd down, right back to Lindsey. Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to 3rd and 10. An important play right here, 3rd and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Throwing is Tagovailoa on 3rd down here. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a 1st down. Johnson on the counter. Pretty nice aggressive run there before being brought down just inside of the 30. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. They fake the handoff. Now Tua. And this is incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
Tagovailoa going to try and throw on 3rd down. He rifles one that's intercepted. It's Kyler Duggar who picks it. And the Pats will have the football as this is taken up past the 30.
And that's a ball that he is going to want to keep, his first career interception in the National Football League.
And I love what teams do when that happens. You bring the ball to the sideline, the equipment guy grabs it, he puts a piece of tape on it, writes on it so that you know what it is, and then they tuck it away so that you can have it for later and put it on your mantle. Pretty good deal for him right there. Now he's eager to get back out on the field and get his second one.
Second and 10, third quarter of the season opener. To throw again, Jones. Quick completion to Henry. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. A first carry here for J.J. Taylor. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield.
That's quite a spot there for his first carry of the game, but obviously they had plenty of faith in him, didn't they?
No question about it. And here, why not go with the fresh legs? Able to push forward, pick up that first.
Meanwhile, the throw here is complete. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Second and two. They give to Taylor out of the gun. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line.
And that's a tired defense out on the field right now. They desperately need a stop to get the ball back to their offense, but they're having trouble getting that done. Another gut-wrenching run right there.
And that'll be incomplete.
You could tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
Second and 10. Back to throw. Jones. Open man right side, Myers. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. So a nice throw there, and CD, I'd have to think you've been impressed with what you've seen thus far here in his debut.
Now, you know me well. I have been impressed because what I've seen is him starting to understand how to play the game in a short amount of time. The dazzling plays, they'll come and with experience, but right now we're seeing him handle the game, make all the smart plays and the right reads.
He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the...
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Ramondre Stevenson making quite a splash with his second touchdown in his NFL debut. And the Patriots, they add on to their lead. Point after, right down the middle. And that will ensure that it will take a touchdown and a two-point conversion to tie it. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. Taken at the goal line. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. Miami set to take over. Still plenty of time here in the fourth quarter. Just a one-possession game, down 8. They'll be looking for the touchdown and two-point conversion. A field goal here on this drive. The Pats are going to get there. Down he goes. The sack recorded. It's a loss of 5, and now it's second down. Another try after the first down sack. Tua over the middle and complete to Waddle. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective.
Well, the pressure gets there, and Tua is going to be taken down. Kyle Van Noy with a big-time sack on third down. It's a loss of 7. Pilardi now on to punt as he sends this one away. Olszewski now to return. Nifty move. Found good room to run there. Returns at 13 yards. And the Patriots take over. Here comes Mac Jones and the rest of the Patriot offense.
And right now, probably just one thing in his mind. It's getting back to the hot start because he's really faded.
And ordinarily when that happens,
and he can't escape, and down he goes. John Jenkins busting through to get him for a loss of six. Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. Looking to throw. Jones setting up a screen for Stevenson. And oh, he's going to be brought down by the face mask. Here come the flags. This is going to get him a first down. So they'll take the yardage and tack on 15 more for the face mask.
Talk about a play that absolutely costs you in the end. Just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, they're marching off another 15 against your squad.
Now a play fake here on first down.
And that'll be caught by the tight end, Keene.
3 yards the gain there, second down.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran it a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line. But once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
On first down, Stevenson. There to make the stop was John Jenkins.
If you're looking for glory, looking to get your name in the headlines, you do not want to play nose tackle. But how about what we just saw there? The ability to hold people up, take on extra blocks, and actually slip them and make a tackle on that play. That's big time.
Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now third down.
On any passes in the middle of the field, Anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested, and often physically. Sometimes that leads to drops.
He'll dump this off to Taylor, complete. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. 3 yards, all they could muster there, and it'll bring up fourth down. Rohrwasser's kick is good. And that will extend their lead even further. So that, CD, an important one here in the fourth quarter.
And that importance cannot be overstated. All eyes on both sidelines were staring that one down all the way. The significance is that they made it a two-score game. Still lots of time left to go, but likely that was their goal at the start of the drive. Get 3 points, make it a two-score game, and they were able to get it done.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And the complexion of this one has changed a fair amount. That last field goal made it a two-score game, so they need to get points out of this drive relatively quickly. Tackle made by Adrian Phillips. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Tua sets up to pass it. Open net is Waddle, complete. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39.
Well, every drive from here out is definitely crucial and critical. They know that they need to get at least 3 here to get it back to a one-score game. I can't imagine that in their huddle, that they're thinking at all about getting a field goal. They want to get into the end zone and then try to get the ball back again.
He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. There's a throw over the middle. It's taken in by his tight end. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down.
All right, this is the time of the game where they're down a couple of scores, and they've really got to get some yards in chunks. And they know the defense doesn't want to give those up, but they've got to find a way to take them anyway.
Now the question is, can they string a few of those together? Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. From midfield, here's Tua. High throw, but he makes the catch. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. That is catch number 300 now for his NFL career. Tua now on first down. And he's going to be taken down here. A sack back at the 32. Lawrence Guy picks up his second sack of the afternoon. This defense, they just continue to feast. 5 sacks now as a unit. It's been quite an afternoon getting to the quarterback.
And we're seeing it come from a variety of places as well. Sometimes just the guys up front getting to them. Other times you have extra guys rushing the quarterback, twists and stunts. It's been a variety, and they've had no way of blocking them.
Throwing now is Tagovailoa. Throw right side, going to be caught here by Waddle. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as he'll be marked down a yard or two past the marker following a gain of 6. And a 2-score game, obviously, every play, every third down. Like we saw there, Matt. Magnified big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get to third down. They need time and conserve as much as possible.
And they'll lose yardage here. Knocked back to the 19-yard line. It's a completed pass, but they lose a full 5 yards.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. And again, it's Tagovailoa. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Devin McCourty picks it off, and the Patriots are going to have it here just past the 25.
Boy, so another interception, CD, and it feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I can be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Back to Stevenson on first down. And able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line. 69 yards rushing for him now with a couple of touchdown runs to boot. So they come up on second down. If they can get another run like we just saw, would likely put an end to this thing. Now a give to Taylor. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. So this will wind up a victory for the New England Patriots. And with that, our journey begins, Charles. Week one in the books. Going to be a great season.
Oh, man, so much to look forward to. Isn't it nice to get a really good game right out of the gate? Preseason behind us. All these games count now, don't they?
Yeah, this is the exciting time with just 1 week gone and plenty of weeks to come. So for the Pats, victory for Mac Jones in his debut at quarterback. And they will hit the road next week to take on the New York Jets. Meanwhile, for the Dolphins, they go down to defeat here in the opener. And they will get a home date next week as they will take on the Buffalo Bills. And for Charles Davis.
Only religion was the moon. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a to you. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework, I was gone. Hustlers and the killers, now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chillin', click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real, about to get real. That's just how I'm feeling.